Good evening, everyone. TSB Television proudly presents high school girls basketball. We take another trip to our backyard in Highland Park High School as they host the Humboldt Hawks in a key St. Paul City Conference matchup. Stick around, the battle for second place will start shortly. Hello, everyone. I'm Mike Peden, joined by Jeremy Daves. And Jeremy, we've got two teams fighting for second, trying to stay on pace with Central for the conference championship and Twin Cities championship appearance. What should we expect tonight?
Well, we're going to expect what I call a small but mighty Humboldt taking on up-and-coming Highland Park. Look for Humboldt to come out in the fast-break offense, and let's see what Highland Park is going to answer to that.
And you talked about small and mighty for Humboldt. Nobody above 5'10" on the roster, but mighty they are. They're led by Angelina Hicks, who is third in the state in scoring with 23.5 points per game, has scored double figures in every game this season. I think she's learned a thing or two from her older sisters that played before her, Ayana and Anessa.
Yeah, I was looking at how many siblings. I was trying to figure out how many siblings do they have. They have a lot of Hicks along the line, but kind of interesting.
The Hicks family has revived that Humboldt program that was once the laughing stock of the conference, but Highland Park is no slouch either. They're led by Kianda Nix, who averages about 10 points a game, 7 rebounds a game, but more importantly, a big presence inside, 2.5 blocks per game. She'll be a big challenge for the Hawks inside.
Yeah, I'm looking to see how that's going to turn out. Like I said, we've talked about Humboldt and their fast break offense and see how Highland Park responds to that. But I'm looking to see what the post is going to do in this game.
Our keys to the game will start with the Humboldt Hawks. First, it's all about ball control. You can't win games if you can't control the ball. Second, they'll need to keep Highland Park out of the foul lane, out of the paint. That's going to be difficult to do if Kianda Nix can get inside on offense and defense. Humboldt will be in big trouble. And finally, they just need to finish in the first game against Highland Park. Humboldt was in the running, but couldn't pull out the win because they had some difficulty finishing baskets that would have given them 10, 11 points, enough to push over the Scots. Speaking of the Scots, their keys to the game, simple. Establish the defense, execute the offense, and challenge Humboldt's shots as they did in the first game of this series. But even if they do, they're going to have a challenge on their hands with Lashay Holt, who had 13 points and 30 rebounds against the Scots. The last 8 games have all been decided by 10 points or less. I can't imagine why this one will be any different.
It's going to be an interesting matchup. I'm looking forward to this tonight.
Starting lineups are coming up next. Stick around. You're watching high school girls basketball on TSB Television. Time for the starting lineups. We'll begin with the visiting Humboldt Hawks. It's Leticia Hernandez, number 5 at guard, getting the start, along with Angelina Hicks, number 11 at guard. Number 15, Alexis Clark at guard. Number 21, Teresa LaRocque at guard. And number 45, Lashay Holt at center, Angelina Hicks. Humboldt's star this year has come up big, being the elder Hicks sister on this year's roster, as we mentioned, 23.5 points per game. Every game she has scored this year has been in double figures. The home team, Highland Park Scots, on the floor will be number 1, Tamara Curtis, at guard. Number 21, Erica Turner, at forward. Number 22, Kianda Nix, at center. Number 24, Silver Moran Stewart at guard. And number 32, Paris Crenshaw at guard. Kianda Nix, Highland's biggest weapon on offense and on defense, averaging 10 points per game, 7 rebounds per game, and 2.5 blocks per game. That concludes our starting lineups. If you'd like to order a DVD copy of this and any other game from TSB Television this year, contact us online at thesportsbrain1.blogspot.com. That's thesportsbrain1.blogspot.com. Angelina Hicks, as we mentioned in the open, third in the state in scoring, but Lashay Holt also among the leaders in the St. Paul City Conference standings. And Highland Park's in three of their players are in the top 10, Morales, Crenshaw, and Nix. And then we mentioned conference implications on the line. Both teams fighting for second place and trying to stay on pace with Central for a conference title and a Twin Cities championship berth.
Looking for a close game today. Like you said, fighting for second place for that spot against Central. And man, the crowd is loud here today.
Highland would have to win out and hope that Humboldt beats Central in the second game of this series, because the Twin Cities tiebreaker scenario, it's a strange one, but how it works is the team with the longest absence from the game gets to go. Humboldt went last year, so they can't tie Central and expect to go on. They would have to beat Central outright this year, but Highland, if they can finish in a tie, they go on.
That's kind of interesting. I never knew that.
I don't make the rules, I just follow it. Humboldt wearing white, Highland Park wearing red. Here we go. As we mentioned, the last eight games of this series has been decided by 10 points or less. Highland holds the edge in that margin, 6-2. Well, Humboldt looking to even this series out. Humboldt won the St. Paul City Conference title last year for the first time in school history, and they won it by beating St. Paul Central in a thrilling fashion, traveling violation on Angelina Hicks.
So it looking like we're going to have the same scenario this year. Humboldt, well, you know, Highland Park came a long way. Looking for either or, they'll take on Central for the city title.
Highland Park has always managed to beat the teams they need to beat, or the teams they're expected to beat. Leticia Hernandez can't get the runner. The difficulty with the Scots is they have trouble beating teams they need to beat, carrying violation on Brad Stewart.
That was a late call there.
They can't beat teams that are better than they are and establish themselves as a legitimate threat. And in their section is Hill Murray, which is a tall order if you want to get to state.
That's going to be a tough one. Hill Murray, a real tough team to take on in the section.
Angelina Hicks, swish.
There we go.
As we mentioned, she has scored double digits in every game this season, stepping up nicely as the elder Hicks sister with the graduation of Ayana Hicks and Anessa Hicks over the last 2 years.
A lot of Hicks.
And we're not talking rednecks.
No, that's not what I meant. I mean,
I said we're not talking. I was trying to go along with you. Jeez. I'm not always serious, you know. That's Paris Crenshaw wearing number 32. Normally wears number 5, but she lost her jersey at a game against North St. Paul. Keonda Nix missed the runner. Angelina Hicks with the rebound. The Hicks all have speed as she faces her way through the hole and finishes.
Remember the beginning of the game, I talked about speed, small but mighty, but speedy, Humboldt, and it's shown on the court right now.
You saw small and mighty in one fell swoop. Crenshaw misses. It's 4-0, Humboldt over Highland. Highland won the first game of the series.
Here we go again.
Angelina Hicks has scored all 6 points of this game.
She is from one court to another. I mean, that's good speed there.
Watch, be careful what I say tonight. The Humboldt players, remember every word I said last year when we televised the Humboldt-Highland game at Humboldt. And so maybe Angelina's seeing the cameras, thinking I got to step up big time. Turner with the steal.
You know, when I watch, like, these girls' games.
Nix and one.
I don't see too many teams who run a fast-paced, fast-break offense like Humboldt does. It's usually half-court, defensive team, or give it to the bigs.
Inner-city basketball at its finest. South, Humboldt, Highland, Roosevelt, they all prefer fast tempos. That's how they play basketball in the cities. Nix with the three-point play.
Kind of like the and-one. Every city will have an and-one team. Hump and Biden looking to play lose some defense here.
Lachey Holt draws the foul. She has stepped up big this year, 8 double-doubles this season. And as we mentioned in the open, a 13-point, 30-rebound game in the first meeting against Highland Park, although that resulted in a loss. Not quite Kevin Love numbers. But I wonder if she watches Kevin Love. Traveling.
Yeah, he had to call that.
You can't jump with the ball and come back down with it without releasing it in some way.
I caught a bit of a crowd tonight along with the band. The band, the cheerleaders.
With no three-pointer from Ashley Morales, who did not get the start tonight but leads the team in scoring.
Here goes that speed.
Angelina Hicks. Here she comes. Spinorama. And wow. The foul is called before the shot.
She can handle the ball. She got the speed. What cannot she do? She reminds me of a kind of a player that plays at Richfield.
Jessica January. Well,
except for the acrobatic cartwheels.
I was going to say, I don't think I've seen Angelina cartwheel or somersault, but she can shoot threes. Bullseye.
I want to see them two go at it in the All-Star game when they had the All-Star game in Arlington. I'm pretty sure them two will make it.
Nix.
Back side, and she did not shoot it.
Morales goes for the mid-range instead. It pays off.
I can see her and Jessica January going at it.
Too bad they're in different classes.
Well, I'm talking about in the All-Star game. I'm thinking
All-Star
him.
Classic.
Yeah.
Well, January can't play in that either. She's not a senior yet, but
oh,
that would be
right.
A fun
yes.
Hypothetical matchup. Meanwhile, Keonda Nix says, get out of here. And Ashley Morales with the payback. Four quick points for Highland Park's leading score.
Oh, who was she passing to?
And Clark.
That was a bad pass.
Turner going back in for the Scots. And for Humboldt, Marissa Franco, number 31. 5'3 junior. Humboldt on the city's west side, although geographically south. High Latino population in that neighborhood. Cinco de Mayo Festival is held there every year.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Highland Park, the alma mater of Jack Morris. You know who Jack Morris is?
Actually, it rings a bell, but I'm not sure who.
Well, you played baseball. He was a pitcher,
okay.
Including the 91 World Series with the Twins.
Oh, you're going way back.
Ashley Morales going back to the basket. Yeah, Morris won 4 World Series with the 84 Tigers, the 91 Twins, and the 92 and 93 Toronto Blue Jays. Went to school with
3 different
here.
Teams.
Morales has scored the last 6 points of this game, and we're tied up, 9-all.
That shot was kind of hard.
That was from Curtis. Angelina has numbers.
Oh, she kicked.
Kick ball.
That would have been an easy 2 points if she would have kicked that ball.
She was looking for Cynthia Ibarra. That's one thing that stepped up over Hicks. Not afraid to dish out a little more. That was a pump fake with Nix in her face. That's one thing that's difficult with Humboldt's small roster. Traveling violation. Humboldt ball. Holt playing only her second year of varsity ball. Hadn't played a single minute until last season. It's called for the foul. And Humboldt, perhaps the bubbliest team I have encountered all season, and we were getting their pictures for the starting lineup graphic. They're throwing all these lines I said last year, throwing out all this other stuff. They wanted redos. They couldn't stop laughing. I pretty much lost it.
So go back to what you said about what happened last year. They didn't forget what happened last year.
We'll get to that at the next stoppage in play. The last time we televised the game, these two teams split last year's series. But in the game we televised and the game that proved pivotal in Humboldt's conference championship, they were trailing by 14 against Highland Park early in the first half, rallied back, won 72-63 on a big performance from Anessa Hicks, who broke the St. Paul City Conference record for most three-point field goals at that game.
Okay.
Then they beat Central the following week to clinch the conference title and bring the Twin Cities championship to Humboldt for the first time as well.
We all know that was Central's rebuilding year last year. We're still rebuilding a little bit, but Central lost all their players due to college.
Ibarra is the first non-Hicks player to get points for Humboldt. Hicks, just 3 points. She has a block. Paris Crenshaw to Morales. Nix has a one-on-one and the advantage. She goes for it, but her shot's off. The rebound went to Ibarra. New player in for Humboldt. LaRock for three. Strong. Haley Green in the game for the Hawks.
I was talking earlier at the JV game. They should make a rule. You cannot wear glasses playing basketball. You should wear goggles. Go back to the old school goggles, the James Worthy specials.
Go. 12-12 in half number one. Clark missed the three. Hernandez with the rebound. This is Ibarra.
3 seconds.
And a turnover, 11-9. Hawks over Scots. Highland Park, a dominant force in basketball back in the 80s, going to 2 straight state tournament appearances with players like Suggs and Tracy Buckman, who is now known as Tracy Buford, the mother of St. Paul Central standout and current golfer Tiara Buford, and Deb Richardson, one of the best coaches the St. Paul City Conference has seen. Haley Green takes
coming.
A broken play into 2 points.
She didn't see that one coming, but it went in for two.
Points are points, no matter how well you see them. Green averages 5 points per game. Paris Crenshaw missed. Jump ball. Humboldt with the possession arrow.
A lot of aggressive going on trying to get the ball. We've seen a lot of jump balls this game.
Crenshaw will take a seat. Ibarra to Green. And Green is fouled.
Like I was saying before, a lot of aggressive going on this game.
Fouls on Curtis, her first. Clark to inbound. LaRock driving left, too strong.
Gets oh, nice rebound. Rebound, she got it back.
But she couldn't finish, and now Curtis is open. But not for long. Now Turner's open, and she's fouled by Ibarra.
Was that a, I thought it would have been a block, but you know, again, I'm just a commentator, not a referee.
We couldn't see that well from up here. That will send Turner to the line. Turner, not the greatest of free throw shooters. Only 31% from the charity stripe.
Oh, that's not good. Well, she makes it there.
Is that a reverse jinx?
Well, 31% from the line. I don't think that's not good. I don't think it's good.
I know, but I mentioned that she makes it. Is that what you call reverse jinx?
Well.
Now did I re-jinx her? Morales for three. No. Rebound, Hernandez. Losing the handle, but Highland Park stepped on the line, so it will stay Humboldt ball.
You mean to tell me that Humboldt only has one ball handler and she's on the bench right now? Or one good ball handler?
Even Hicks needs a rest. But keep an eye on Holt, too. You don't know when she can turn on the afterburners. Here's Clark. To LaRock. Had an opening, but couldn't finish. And picking it up is Briara Verney, number 55. Morales missed. LaRock with the rebound. Green. Swish.
That was good. But she had number 15 open for backside. But
Ibarra with the rebound.
Highland Park cannot find a bucket whatsoever.
They're only down by five. And Green can't make it. And Curtis stepped on the line. That was the right call.
But they're missing a lot of shots.
Much to the dismay of Deb Williams. A Como Park alum who participated in the first women's game of the Inner City Alumni Association. The event that's hosted by Henry Combs, that used to be the Central Mechanic Arts rivalry.
Okay.
They added a women's game last year, and Deb Williams took part in it. She made a three-pointer.
I gotta go back and check that.
We have it on YouTube.
Okay.
Hicks is back in. And look at that awareness. She knew a Highland Park player poked it, so she danced around, made sure she did not touch that ball in any way.
That's good awareness there.
She scored the first 9 points of the game for the Hawks. Can't make it 12. Jump ball, possession arrow, Highland Park. But give credit to Franco for continuing to fight. All 5 foot 3 inches of her.
She said, give me that ball.
Nix is back in.
Oh, the forearm. There's a lot of tension going on here between Highland and Humboldt. What do you think?
When you've had a series as close as Highland and Humboldt, even though Highland has the edge in terms of finishing close games, things do get a little tense. They know they can play with each other. Holt is fouled.
Nice rebound and putback, and got fouled. Well, not a putback, but second chance shot.
Highland Park uses up its last foul to give, and that sends Holt to the line, averaging 11.1 points per game. Does not make the front end. Holt has not scored yet. But again, 8 double-doubles this season. In the win over St. Paul Central, at Central, she had 22 points and 15 rebounds. Look out, Kevin Love. Ooh. And the Rock will be called for the push.
Every now and then I watch how they come down with the knees, but I just saw a girl, well, we saw a girl tore ACL at the Minneapolis South game on Saturday.
That was Rebecca Sparkman. And the strange thing about that was she didn't even look like it was that part of a play, that much contact.
Well,
really she wasn't. She just fell awkwardly.
Well, her foot plant, but her upper body went forward, but the other lower body just stopped.
Angelina.
They cannot find a way to get the ball to Holt. I'm sorry, not Holt, but Nix. Ooh, nice crossover.
Holt is fouled again. But she was 0 for 2 her first time up. Highland now in the penalty.
Nice crossover by Nix.
Holt, not only an outstanding player, but an outstanding student getting mostly A's and B's in her classes at Humboldt Secondary School. They merged the junior high with the senior high a few years ago to stem declining enrollment. But that girls' conference title last year helped revitalize the school. There is a huge pride in Humboldt High School now.
Like I always say, Humboldt always ran a good program, but you know, Central obviously had the better edge of them winning state titles.
Well, they have a coach that won 2 state titles and is the winningest coach in conference history. Knicks spin move, no good. Rebound, Hicks.
Oh, that's a nice one.
And with the roll is Ibarra.
Highland defenders.
Nix is struggling this time.
Yes, she is.
Holt will get more free throws. She has yet to score 0-for-4 from the charity stripe.
Well, I'm pretty sure she has about 10 rebounds already.
She's a threat for a double-double every game. But I'm surprised at how much Nix is struggling early. Only 3 points. That's been one of Highland Park's issues this season, is that his consistency. Holt finally with their first point.
When your best player struggles, your team struggles.
Well, in the case of Highland Park, they really don't know who their best player is. I talked to the coaches in pregame, and they say it's a different player every night. One night it might be Nix, another night it might be Morales, it might be Crenshaw, it could be Silver Moran Stewart.
Well, let me rephrase that. If your big player is struggling, then your team's going to have problems.
Or if you're the Wolves, you just have problems, period.
Well.
Love can't clone himself and start every position for them.
Pretty soon the Wolves going to get desperate.
Morales, no good. It's 19-10. And Nix draws the foul. We'll see if she can get some momentum at the free throw line. Nix, a 63% free throw shooter.
That's a little bit more better than 31%.
Had a 3-point play in the opening minutes, and until that free throw was the limit of her offensive production.
Humboldt's doing a real good job defending Nix. Keeping her from scoring.
5 points for Nix.
Looking like Highland Park is playing the man defense.
Nix is bumped by Crenshaw, so she will get free throws. And it's really nice to see Humboldt hasn't missed a beat. Even though they've changed coaches this year. Last year, Chris Vanderhyde led the team to a conference title, then left to take on a college job. This year, Paul Richardson took the helm, and it's the same Humboldt team as last year in terms of competitiveness. That was a one-on-one situation. But Holt is there for the cleanup. Holt, after missing her first 4 free throws, now has 4 quick points.
Both teams playing man-to-man defense. I don't see too much of that often.
Morales, no good from the corner. Hicks with the rebound. She's doing pretty well with the boards. And that was a tough shot. And Holt with another rebound. Hernandez in and out. Rebound Green. And she's blocked by Nix.
Humboldt has had more offensive rebounds.
And nobody
what
above 5'11 on the roster. Clark inbounding. Finds Hicks. Holt. And she draws a foul on Pasha Crenshaw. This time, Humboldt in the double bonus, so Angelina will get 2 free throws. She's been stuck at 9 points for a while. No, it was on Holt. That's right, it was on Holt. But it's still a double bonus. And Highland will take a timeout with 7:04 remaining in the first half. Again, Holt. No, it's all right. Holt, in just your second year of varsity ball, you have to think, over the next 2 years, the Humboldt coaching staff will work on her free throw shooting. Because as many rebounds as she gets, as big a presence as she is inside, they'll want her to make some clutch free throws.
I'm just shocked at how many offensive rebounds Humboldt has right now. I mean, you would think it'd be the other way around with Highland Park's bigs, but it's Humboldt getting all the rebounds.
And I'd say the reason why Highland Park is still in this game, Holtzman at the line so much, but she only has two free throws of seven tries.
Yeah, that's one thing she got to improve as a career and season goes by. But season was old, but her next year, work on the foul free throw percentage. Because what will happen is, I mean,
they won't have a senior Hicks next year, so Holt will likely be looked upon to lead the team.
I'm pretty sure it's more Hicks.
Well, there is another Hicks, Alexandria, but she will only be a sophomore. Holt gets the back end. She now has five. Nix kicks out. Morales has struggled so far, getting three field goals, but nothing from beyond the arc. Tasha Crenshaw.
Back door was wide open. Looked like Humboldt went back to playing his own defense.
Nix with the assist. Highland's really keyed in on Angelina.
Look at that, another offensive rebound.
Two offensive rebounds, and it pays off as Green picks up her sixth point of the game. And Ashley Morales with a quick response, she now has eight.
Highland Park is really sleeping down in the paint today.
Hernandez, tough angle. Stay Humboldt ball. What did you say? Small but mighty?
Yep, small but mighty. That's my own.
And that's been Humboldt's theme all game. Hicks on the line.
Catch and shoot. I don't see too much of that coming from a girl player, from a female player.
She was on the line, so that's a two-pointer. Grant Stewart off target.
If that was her answer, then I don't know what to say.
Holt with the rebound. Clark
look
with the
at
basket
that assist
on the other end.
She making it look so fancy.
Are you sure that's not a Nessa in there? Nix with the assist and Turner with the basket. I was just about to call it an assist, but Turner maybe a little too close for comfort, but still a basket. Carrying violation on Clark.
Yeah, she paused for a moment and she carried. I mean, made it a little obvious. She just kept going with the ball. A little hop step, what she used to in the hop step. A little hop skip step.
Paris Crenshaw back in for the Scots, going to her twin sister, Turner. Free throws coming. As you mentioned, Turner 31% from the line. She is one of two so far. Humboldt now in the penalty. They have a 10-point lead, 28-18, with 5 minutes to go in half number one. That was a one-on-one situation. And that went off. Paris Crenshaw. Well, Humboldt catches a break.
Whoa, she traveled.
Yes. That was the right call. Angelina Hicks showing her unselfishness here, but you do wonder if she may have to start being a little more selfish. Still a long way to go, but I'm sure Humboldt wants to send a statement to the Scots.
Wait, go back to what you're talking about, Hicks, the way she's been passing the ball and the catch and shoot.
Moran Stewart was open. Tried to feed to Morales, but the pass is a little off, and they couldn't pursue. No shot clock, of course. So teams can take as long as they want on their possessions.
Humboldt looking like they're back playing the man defense.
Nix with Holt.
Oh, whoa, whoa. I don't think that was a foul.
That was a tough call. She used her pivot and she used her dribble. That was a tough call. We're not down there.
Holt didn't even jump.
You don't have to jump, but if you're not set, you won't get the charge call. Nick's 6'1", junior center. Misses the back end.
Whoa, get it out of here.
Deonda Nix, not afraid of Humboldt in the paint.
The fly swatter.
She's a blocker that makes even Willie Taylor cringe, the coach at St. Paul Central. And she's got another year left with the Scots. Paris Crenshaw can't go coast to coast. And Turner can't draw the foul. Nix with the rebound, and she does.
Okay, that was a foul there.
No doubt.
But that last possession, I don't know about that one.
We don't have a review system. We can't ask Mike to stop tape, rewind, and have the referees look at a tiny LCD monitor to go over the call. It's just not going to happen. The calls the refs make are the calls everyone's got to live with. Nix, I believe, has three blocks now.
Pulling up some Darko numbers.
Darko? Darko's having quite the renaissance, actually. He was the butt of jokes for many years, especially when he signed that $20 million deal with the Wolves. Everyone's thinking, why would you sign a bust? And he's done what he needs to do.
He needs to just fit in the right system, and the Wolves is the right system for him right now.
He's no Kevin Love, but then again, who is?
Well, Kevin Love is your versatile, well, not versatile, but your unique player.
Franco.
Nice
look
pass.
At that. Santana Castillo.
Franco is an unselfish player. She's had like three assists already in this game.
And another humble foul. We could be here a while. Both teams now in the double bonus. Well, if it comes to depth, we see Humboldt sending in their ninth player, so they can go deep. Paris Crenshaw with two shots. Missed the front end.
They're not
59%
making
free throw shooter.
Highland is not making their foul shots today.
Highland really doesn't have a deadly free throw shooter on the roster.
That's not good.
Well, the reason why you see so many teams in college, in high school, and you wonder why are they missing so many free throws, they've done some studies. I read a New York Times article on this. Free throws account for only 20 total points on average, 20% of your total points on average.
But it's still points.
Well, here's the thing. No one thinks about it until free throws decide a game. Give credit to Franco.
Franco is hustling. I like how she's hustling.
She's not giving up, that's for sure. Neither is Highland Park, but Kumu can't make it. Jump ball, Humboldt with the possession arrow.
Franco reminds me of Charles Oakley back in the 80s and 90s. A player who likes to hustle and goes after the ball.
And to finish up that free throw discussion, no one makes a big deal about free throws until they decide a game. And there's no bigger example than the 2008 NCAA championship between Kansas and Memphis.
Oh, yes.
Memphis had a few free throw shooters. Well, they would have had their title stripped anyway.
Derrick Rose and Douglas Roberts. Nice one.
And Clark.
Nice pass.
With the layup. But Clark looking a little tired out there. And stopping his play as Camus' shoe went untied.
Well, you know, we talked about it. You know, Humboldt and their fast break offense will slow, well, tire Highland down. Well, there you go.
LaRocque can't make the steal. And she does, but there's still a scramble. Highland has a possession arrow, and the jump ball means they keep possession.
They're hustling.
2:33 remaining. We'd like to remind you that at halftime, we'll have first half stats and analysis and a performance from the Highland Park Pep Band.
The band.
Curtis has not scored. She only averages 3.8, though. Camus looking for a target.
Oh, this Humboldt's ball.
Looking for Samantha Agranoff, a 6'1 freshman center, one of Highland Park's new players, but for the most part, they've returned last year's roster. LaRocque to Angelina.
Speed. There you go.
Not even Knicks can phase her.
That was actually a nice setup play. She threw the ball over. So number 21 grabbed the ball and passes this to Hicks for the easy layup.
13 points for Angelina Hicks, and she's well on her way to maintaining her lead in the St. Paul City Conference. She's only 3 points behind Jessica January for second place in the scoring race this year. Number one, of course, Rebecca Dahlman, putting up about 30 a game for Ram.
And we're above Highland Park's bench, and the coach for Highland Park is not too happy with what she's seen in the court today.
Meanwhile, I'm trying to remember, what's the song that Highland Park was performing?
Oh, I wasn't even paying attention. I was listening to the coach here at Highland Park.
Well, you're listening to what matters, I suppose. I wander off.
Yeah.
You're a gym rat. You pay attention to what needs to be paid attention to.
Yeah.
I wander off, and before you know it, I'll start going up. I'll look. Oh, look. A pulley. A speaker. Yeah. 2:12 remaining in half number one. 34-21. Humboldt over Highland Park. Knicks going out to Camus, and she's too strong.
Air ball, whoa.
Highland has not found their shots. And a push foul on Humboldt. It's on Castillo. Double bonus, of course. That means free throws for Tamara Curtis. Curtis shooting 36% from the charity stripe. Deb Williams getting in Camus' face.
Oh, yeah, she is not happy today.
A very intense coach.
Yeah, I can see that.
Long-time head coach, though, for the Scots. Nix with the rebound. No basket.
Whoa, she's traveling.
But Green may have gotten away with a traveling violation, but Curtis with the poke. Paris Crenshaw drives right. Yes. Crenshaw's first field goal. Highland Park now down by 11. LaRock loses the handle, and she fouls Camus. Yoa Camus, 5'7", junior forward. Only 40% from the free throw line. The best player in terms of the charity stripe, Melissa Hutchinson, 14 of 16, but she's not in right now.
Well, Holt's back in the game. Maybe they can do something. As Humboldt is up by 10 points. Off the backboard.
A loss starts. Clark back in. Humboldt going back with their starters. That was touched by Highland, so no backcourt violation. Stop, pop, no good from Hicks. Off of Camus. Humboldt ball, 1:19 left in the first half. Hicks.
Oh, push off.
For the push. No free throws because it's a player control foul. This game living up to the series over the last 4 years. Close, tense, exciting, nail biting. Nix with the cleanup.
Oh, put back.
Curtis wanted the charge.
Highland started to come back.
Humboldt wanted the charge. They didn't get it. And Nix now with 9 points. Camus.
Look at the crowd.
Doesn't get the steal, but you said it. Crowd fired up. If they see effort, they will respond positively. This is getting loud, and it's a small gym too, so noise.
Oh, the foul.
Clark going to the line.
The crowd is getting into this game.
And with a gym as small as this is, sound reverberates quite easily. But they quiet down out of respect for their opponent. Clark averaging 5.7 points per game this season. Zachy has already approached the scoring average. Humboldt with an 8-point lead. Agranoff, no good. Right call.
Highland Park just cannot get a rebound.
Coaching staff didn't talk about this in terms of keys to the game, but rebounding, a big key. Holt's open, one-on-one with Nix, and look at that.
There you go, nice stop. Stop, nice. Put up the backboard, easy bucket.
Knew Nix was coming, stop, let her go by.
Nice block, oh.
That was Ibarra. Agranoff missed a three. Hernandez called for the foul.
Reps are working this game.
They don't get paid overtime. I don't imagine that's their motive. But if it is, well, it wouldn't be. Calling more fouls, does that mean they get more pay? Again, though, we are up here. We are not down there.
I need to be down there.
Well, give the Minnesota State High School League a call.
I will do that.
They're always looking for officials.
No, I'm in coaching.
Oh, coaching? Well, you'll have to talk to the schools about that one. I don't know which school you want to coach.
Doesn't matter.
Well, I don't know. Does Stillwater have any openings?
No.
You're on pretty good terms with their staff. Camille with a steal and another foul.
She passed it right to her.
I will be curious to see what the foul situation looks like at the end of the first half.
I was just thinking about that.
All 3 points from Camus have come from the charity strike.
Seven-point lead.
5 of 6 for a player that only shoots 40%. Holt one-on-one again, and this time, Nix disrupts her drive. 15 seconds, Highland Park with all the momentum right now. They're down by as much as 13. They've cut it to 7. Have a chance to trim that margin even further, and Curtis will do exactly
that.
Humboldt with time. They got to hurry. And they took too much time. And that's how the first half will end. 32-37. Humboldt with a 5-point lead. Highland Park, though, trims it from a 13-point deficit. And I have a feeling this game will go just like the last 8 have in this series.
Well, Highland Park made a small run towards the end of the first half. So it's going to be interesting in the second half, see what happens.
Well, we'll take a break and entertain you with the Highland Park Pep Band and come back with our first half stats and analysis.
Thank you.
welcome back to High School Girls Basketball as TSB Television continues its coverage all season long. We resume our broadcast of Highland Park and Humboldt, a St. Paul City Conference battle with second place on the line. Let's take a look at our first half stats and analysis with Jeremy Daves, who's joining me in the booth. Humboldt with a 37-32 lead, led by Angelina Hicks, who has a game-high 13 points. As of now, Lachey Holt with 7, but struggling from the free throw line, just 3 of 8.
That's probably why that, Highland Park is in this game so far.
Haley Green with 6 points. Humboldt 4 of 8 from the charity stripe in this game so far. Highland, they're in this game because they are 12 of 20 from the free throw line, getting 5 of 6 from Yoa Kamu. Keonda Nix leads the team with 9. Ashley Morales has 8. And that's about it. The players you would expect to step up are stepping up.
Yeah, we talked about it in the beginning of the game. Now the second half is here. Let's see what happens in the second half.
And the biggest surprise on either side, Green and Kamu, with their 6 and 5 points respectively. To purchase a DVD copy of this program, just visit us online at thesportsbrain1.blogspot.com. That is thesportsbrain1.blogspot.com. We'd like to thank RandStadium.tv for providing support throughout the season in webcasting our games for the 2010-2011 season. And now the pep band is hitting off.
You don't leave in the second half. You stay to the end of the game. That's how it's supposed to happen. What is wrong with these bands here in Minnesota?
Have a chat with their band director, but we'd like to thank them for their performance at halftime. Angelina Hicks can't get the runner. Holt rips another rebound down. Hernandez gets the bounce. That's her first field goal. How many rebounds does Holt have?
She's got to have about 15 by now.
I wish they had a statistician post rebounding numbers for Humboldt. I'd love to see what Holt's looks like.
Foul trouble
is going to be something especially to watch for on Humboldt's side. Both Hicks and LaRock have 3 fouls. 2 more and they're disqualified. Clark gets tagged with her 2nd, and Crenshaw, who had 3 points in half number 1, at the line. One of the cheerleaders went 2. They had 5. Now they have 4.
Whoa. You need to check her eyes on that shot there.
You don't see that often.
Yeah.
Hicks is open.
Easy bucket.
A little too close for comfort perhaps for Paul Richardson, but that's good enough for her 15th point.
She was already down by the time they passed the ball.
Well, she's quick. Small but mighty, just like you said.
Yep.
Turner with a swish. She now has 5. Holt had an opening, but backs off. Clark is blocked by Turner. Moran Stewart was looking for Crenshaw, and that pass was deflected. Good job by Humboldt's defense getting back in the paint.
Yeah, she read that like a book.
Nix, too strong. Another rebound by Holt, and this time she's in trouble. Jump ball, Humboldt with the possession arrow.
Yes.
They call it Highland Park ball. They had the possession arrow facing the wrong way. Turner, too strong. Rebound goes to Crenshaw. Highland wanted a foul, won't get it.
Nix was wide open in that backside.
Nix
with a nice steal.
Hernandez with the steal. Hicks, one-on-one. Loses the ball to Curtis. Highland Park with numbers. Curtis racing down and draws the blocking foul on Holtz. But it's ruled a non-shooting foul.
It looked like Hicks was fouled in their last possession, but they didn't call it.
Holtz third.
Oh, they're in a lot of foul trouble now.
Officials calling it tight. I have a feeling we're going to see quite a few reserves before the game's out. The Rock has three. Hicks has a space, goes to the hole, but it's disrupted. And a Highland Park foul.
Wilmo took her head off there.
Foul after the shot. Moran, Stewart, and Camus, the only two Highland Park players in significant foul trouble. Turner picks up her second. Clark, the inbounder. LaRock just gets in there.
Well, they're double-teaming Hicks.
Hicks can't get the runner. Disgusted, as she knows Paris Crenshaw is going to get a layup out of that.
We got a close game going here.
It's a four-point game. Humboldt led by as much as 13. Could this possibly mirror?
Whoa, get it out of here!
Could this possibly mirror what we saw last year at Humboldt, where it was Highland in the lead before Humboldt came back? Highland Park attempting to stay on pace with St. Paul Central. They were swept by the Minutemen in conference play this year, so they would need Humboldt to beat Central a second time to go to the Twin Cities game.
Real close game going here. 15 minutes left to the game. I'm calling athletic director. What's going on here?
Stoppage in play with 15:14 remaining.
It's not good when you call athletic director.
I'm not sure what the stoppage in play was. I hope it's not for us.
We didn't do anything wrong.
Angelina Hicks with the cleanup. They're double teaming her.
Yes, they are.
But she's still finding a way to get put baskets in. She has 17. Nix in the paint. Gets the spinner.
Somebody's gonna have to play. Somebody have to double team on Nix pretty soon.
Nix, 6'1", hard to do. Curtis attempting to steal, but the out of bounds line is her enemy. Nix, the first Highland Park player to break double digits. She has 11, and she has a few blocks to boot. Ibarra inbounds it.
Gotten a double, triple.
For three, no good.
Oh, that's way too hard.
Angelina Hicks knew she didn't have a good angle, but she threw it up anyway, and it pays off by drawing a foul.
Well, she knows she won't get to the foul line one way or another.
I wonder if she participates in track.
I wonder what was Francisco was thinking making that shot. That's not her range. That's one thing that might hurt Humboldt this game is free throw percentage, free throw shooting.
They were 4 of 8 in the first half, now 4 of 9.
There we go.
Humboldt struggling to get to the line and struggling to capitalize when they get on the line. Knicks in the paint again. Fade away. Yes.
Somebody got to put a body on her, double team her, slow it down, do something.
One possession game. Hicks nearly loses the ball. And she draws another foul. This time it's on Curtis. A very tight game by Curtis.
She has three fouls.
This keeps up, you and Mike have to go in there.
Whoa.
No backcourt violation because it's off an inbounds.
Whoa, look at Franco.
Franco with the Janelle McCarville pick.
She didn't even move, and just bounced out, boom.
And she's 5'3".
5'3 stocky. All upper body.
Low center of gravity. Moran Stewart cannot reel in the steal. 14:09 left in the second. 44-41. Humboldt with a 3-point lead. They've led by as much as 13. Ibarra.
Oh, next second bounce. There you go.
Points are points. That's 6 for Cynthia.
There goes Knicks going to work again.
Knicks finding her stroke in the second half. 15 points for Highland Park's top player. LaRock has numbers, feeds to Green.
There you go.
Seeing a flurry of points now. Green with 8.
All right, this is going to work again.
Green averaging 5 points per game. Camus feeding to Knicks. Knicks doesn't draw the foul, but another layup. Knicks now has 17. 8 points in the second half, and we still have 13 minutes to go.
For 3.
No good.
That's rebound, pick back.
Barra, no put back. Jump ball. Can you feel the intensity of this series?
Oh, yes.
12:56 left, and now Paul Richardson takes a timeout.
We got a good ball game here.
Keonda Nix was struggling in the first half, and all of a sudden she's finding her stroke, getting hooks, layups, you name it.
Yeah, she is going to work in the paint. There's nobody for Humboldt to answer against Nix. I mean, Knicks. I'm getting mixed up with Knicks and Hicks too.
It's difficult. They rhyme. I swear I'm surprised they're not involved in any Mother Goose rhyme. One of those nursery rhymes you probably could. Knicks and Hicks. And that's been the story of the series the last few years. Knicks versus Hicks. Except the Hicks keep on changing.
Yeah. It looks like it's going to be here for a while too.
What are the odds that this game is decided by 10 points or less?
I don't think I see that happening no time soon if it keeps up like this.
Well, if it finishes within 10 points, it will be the 9th time in a row in this series.
Whoa, what was she doing?
Was that a Jim Marshall copycat? Hicks for 3.
Oh, not flying.
Only one tray from Angelina. Camus. Short. Vernick, no putback.
Whoa. Is that a foul?
It's a foul.
I'm pretty sure. I thought the ref was going to call double dribble.
Clark out. Holt in for Humboldt. The foul is on Nix.
Maybe Holt can play some defense against Nix.
Clark staying in. I thought she was going out. Holt's been a huge presence on the boards for the Hawks.
And she's drawing the foul.
And that's Highland Park's last to give, so Humboldt will be in the bonus for the final 12 minutes and 16 seconds of this game. And with as many fouls as we've seen on either end, it's going to come down to free throws.
Now the question is, can Humboldt make their foul shots? That is the question.
But we've seen so many players in for both teams, they can absorb this barrage of fouls we've seen today.
Well, Nix is coming out.
Williams might be resting her for a final push because she knows it's going to get tough and dirty if the first 24 minutes are any implication. Hicks with 20.
Oh. Oh!
Vernig got it. Vernig's first field goal. A lot of balance tonight from both teams. Green,
oh, nice
by Vernig. Highland Park can tie with a three. Agranoff open, but Holt pokes it away.
Nice awareness by Holt.
Players have scored tonight for both teams. Agranoff is
1 point game.
A 1 point game. Holt travels, and Highland Park has a chance to take their first lead of the game. .11:29 left. Humboldt with four fouls to give. No foul called there.
Baseline.
Curtis can't do it. Larocque with the rebound. Hicks is open down court. And Moran Stewart has no chance.
That speed is going to be a factor as well.
And a foul on Larocque. That's going to be her fourth. One more and she is out.
Oh, what's this? We've seen... The little sister of
Alexandria Hicks is suiting up, number 25. Larocque will sit. Larocque has struggled tonight, but you don't want to lose a starter. Morales, that would have tied it. Alexandria Hicks with her first rebound.
Whoa, she just threw it up.
Ibarra was there to take it in. Angelina Hicks is stepping out. Hernandez, no bounce. Contact, but no foul. Moran Stewart is fouled by Alexandria Hicks.
Well, she can give a foul. She just got in the game.
Alexandria averaging 4.7 points per game. It's ruled a non-shooting foul. No, they do rule it a shooting foul. That sends Silver Moran Stewart to the line. She has yet to score, averaging 7.7 points a game. No, now they rule a non-shooting foul. I thought that was a non-shooting foul from the start. But Humboldt with only two to give. Vernig, open, no good. Moran Stewart can't finish.
What happened to the offensive rebound for Humboldt?
Morales, short. Ooh. And Hicks can't bring in the board. Highland Park with another possession. Alexandria almost looks like a clone of Angelina.
Whoa, nice one.
Holt with
nice
a steal. She crashed into the Gatorade tub. Meanwhile, Highland Park.
Oh, got an injury.
Holt holding her knee. She crashed into the Gatorade container. She's right under us. And the reason why play did not stop, we should point this out, and it looks like a Highland Park player is banged up. It's Vernick. She's going to sit out.
Holt with a shoulder injury.
Is standing up. Vernig with a shoulder injury. The reason why the play did not stop was because Highland Park had possession. When an opposing team has possession, the team with an injured player cannot call a timeout. It's a variation of the team without possession not being able to call a timeout. Otherwise, I think the Wolves would have called.
She's down right now, holding her knee.
And we might have a stoppage in play for a while because a lot of ice and water fell onto the court, and that's not safe.
Oh, no.
If it's not cleaned up. Wow. 10:07 left.
1-point game.
52-51. While we have the stoppage in play, we'd like to talk about one program that's fallen off the radar. Story was released on it today, Minneapolis North.
Oh, yes, yeah, so we talked about
the Polar Plunge. It was reported in the Star Tribune. We talked about it off broadcast and how the basketball program has essentially gone the way of the school. Richardson now over checking out Holt. Minneapolis North, just a sad story for fans of North who remember the day when North was feared throughout the metro area. The boys team won 3 straight state titles in the mid to late 90s. The girls team won 5 titles under Coach Faith Johnson Patterson. 2 in '97 and '98.
And Holt's walking.
And then 3 straight from 03 through 05. Holt's walking, putting weight on it. That's a good sign to see. We saw an ACL injury at our last game, Eden Prairie, Minneapolis South, and whenever they're holding their knee, every fan holds their breath.
And the ice is
still now Vernick's going back in. Possibly. No, they're taking a look at the shoulder. But the stoppage in play worked to Vernick's advantage. Curtis with the steal. Moran Stewart can't hang on.
Oh,
put that in!
Off the backboard. And
Highland
first
Park
lead.
With their first lead of the game.
Oh,
and Green takes a broken play, and they send a couple Highland Park staff to clean up that mess. Green with the strip. Agranoff, short. Moran Stewart. 9:33 to go. Agranoff is blocked. Alexandria picks it up, and she's fouled.
She had her head down the whole time. She looked up, she would have passed to for easy bucket number 15, but she was dribbling with her head down.
That's something she will learn over time, and she's at the line because she knows that Humboldt is in the bonus. The officials do not know that yet. They have her lining up behind the inbounds line. Now they send her back to the charity stripe. Highland with 17 fouls. It's a one-on-one situation for the freshman. I'm sure she'll learn over the years to keep your eye on the basket.
That's something you cannot do. You can't dribble with your head down.
And it's a good thing the staff is over there to clean up the water spill. Paris Crenshaw open.
Oh,
in and out! Moran Stewart, no! No foul! Ibarra picks it up, loses it. And Alexandria will be tagged for her second foul. Humboldt now with 1 to give. Santana Castillo getting ready to go back in for the Hawks. Humboldt. Ibarra looks like she's winded. Morales, short, and that's off green.
Oh, it's going to be on Highland's ball.
It was off green.
Okay.
Green touched it. Now the cheerleaders are sitting down. I think they're afraid they're going to get tackled. Next.
Going to work.
With the finish.
There's no answer for her.
Humboldt's reserves, just not as poised. Angelina's back in. Green stops, pops. No. And a foul. Castillo draws it as she goes down. The most physical game we've covered all season.
Yeah, I think I agree with you on that one. Third personal foul.
As the fouls pile up.
This might be a reserve game by the time 3 minutes hit.
Depth will be huge.
The foul shots will be huge as well.
Castillo with just one field goal. Humboldt's free throw shooting, their Achilles heel tonight. And if I'm Highland Park, they've sent in 10
players. Nice steal.
That's Clark. Angelina. Blocked by Nix. Highland Park ball. If I'm Highland Park, I know the foul situation isn't rosy, but I would look into sending Humboldt to the line. As they haven't proven that they can be clutch yet. Crenshaw's fouled, and that's Humboldt's last to give. So that means we're going to have free throws for the last 8 minutes and 17 seconds. If we're lucky, we might be back in time for dessert. Crenshaw with 6.
Holt's coming back in.
Still favoring her knee.
That might slow it down a bit.
You think Highland Park notices it?
We'll find out in a minute.
To move with the rebound, Morales.
Oh!
Bullseye! 5-point lead for Highland Park. Alexandria Hicks with her first field goal of the game.
And Holt is hurt again.
That's her fourth foul. And she's been
Holt,
a big presence inside.
Holt is taking a beating as of right now. Actually, both teams are taking a beating.
Winning the rebounding battle now.
Well, Highland Park is back up the top.
Highland Park calls a timeout with a 4-point lead, 60-56 remaining. You really see the difference when Holt is not on the floor for the Hawks.
She's been taking a beating. So
her knees, her face. She's going to need some ice.
Well, Mix has been hot this second half.
10 points for Nix in the second half after just 9 in the first. I think she just needed to warm up.
Yeah.
Angelina Hicks leading all scores with 22. She has 9 in this half, but Highland Park knows how much of a threat she is, and they're making Humboldt's other players try and step up. Senior to freshman.
Yeah, they're trapping.
Jump ball, and that goes Highland Park's way as they have the possession arrow. 7:28 remaining in the second half. Holt getting iced up. Green pokes it away. Alexandria Hicks stepping out. Leticia Hernandez stepping in. Camus, no good. Humboldt ball.
Four-point lead for Highland Park.
Franco did not have good positioning there. Crenshaw.
Franco is, to me, like a defensive player. I don't think she scores that many points.
Just 2.9 a game.
I mean, she's lucky she gets 2 probably from the foul line. What was that? Oh!
That was a microcosm of this series over the last 8 games. That's what it was. No foul.
She
no matter.
Going to work.
No problem. Knicks with 21. Given how many fouls these officials called, I'm almost afraid. I'm starting to wonder if any form of contact will be called as a foul. Angelina Hicks shaking her head, wondering, how did we let a 13-point lead evaporate?
Well, the post position, that's what the problem was.
And Holt has 4 fouls, and the way the officials have called this game, when do you send her back in? Franco?
I mean, does she really think she's a 3-point shooter?
No, it wasn't off target. 3-point shots are hard to make.
And Humboldt players looking at the referee for a foul, which did not get.
Highland with a chance to ice the game. Humboldt will take a full timeout with 5:38 to go. Not a bad idea. Humboldt looking a little ragged out there.
Well, what I noticed that every time Humboldt goes up for a shot and gets hit, they look at the referee. Highland Park's on the other end going for an easy bucket.
You can't worry about what the officials do and do not call. You just have to play your game.
That's what's hurting Humboldt right now.
The officials are going to call what they're going to call. the calls they make are the calls everyone has to live with. Just play your game. Don't be looking at the officials for foul.
Yes,
because Highland Park is making Humboldt pay for that.
And I agree with you on that.
The way things are going right now, I'd say player of the game honors with 5:38 to go. Pretty easy to say who would get that. We will have interviews with our players of the game following the conclusion of this game. In the longest game of the season, perhaps the longest game of my career.
Longest game of your career.
This keeps up. I may not have time to get ready for the Heritage Christian St. Paul Academy game that we have scheduled next Tuesday. Thankfully, I'm taking a day off. I'll still be at the game, I just won't be calling it. Clark for three.
Wow.
No good. Humboldt just can't find their shot. And a half that's all Highland Park. Hernandez forces Turner to take a bad shot, and LaRock, ill-advised pass.
To just threw it to somebody.
That's what's killed Humboldt. The passing lanes.
Ooh, a lot of errors has been killing Humboldt this game.
Green with the steal. Once again, Green with the foul. Free
now,
throws
why
coming
you,
for Curtis.
Why would you steal the ball knowing that you're not a point guard and try to dribble it down court instead of passing it to your point guard?
Holt going back in. Four fouls. You get a feeling this might be Humboldt's last chance to stay in this game. Curtis at the line. Two clutch free throws give Highland their largest lead in the game at the most critical point of the game.
Yeah, I'm with Hicks. How did you lose a 13-point lead?
A reverse of what we saw last year in our Humboldt Highland game. LaRock is fouled.
Should be shooting three.
Humboldt was in the bonus anyway. It's a benefit for the Hawks, though, because they get the clock stopped with 4:33 to go. But LaRock is tired. Richardson is pulling over Hicks and Clark. Have a word with them. LaRock has struggled tonight. She normally gets 10.5 a game.
Everybody has a bad game, I guess.
Those were her first 2 points. Humboldt needs stops, and they've had plenty of chances, but they've been unable to capitalize on them.
Oh, almost a foul there. It's been over with for Hicks. Nothing new.
Kiana Nix knew Holt had 4 fouls and took advantage of it. 14 points this half. Angelina Hicks, you can't fault her for her effort, doing anything she can. Offensive foul on Highland Park. It's on Crenshaw.
It looked like some tension going on between them two there.
It's a second personal. More importantly, Humboldt now in the double bonus. They don't shoot free throws because, again, it's a player control foul.
Humboldt has run out of time. They need to do something.
Rock. With their first field goal. Needed that badly. 66-60. Humboldt needs stops.
What are they doing? Highland's doing everything they can to drain the clock out.
Curtis.
Whoa.
Angelina hit.
Get it out of here.
But she gets the ball back.
Try it again.
I'll block you once, I'll block you twice, and I'll respond with a layup. Oh,
this game might be over.
Curtis.
I don't know. This game pretty much might
what
be it.
What a comeback by Highland Park.
Wow,
and now
look
the cheerleaders are going back out there.
Oh, you know, they're rested for like 10 minutes. You know, you got to rest. I mean, they do like
they
cookies and
pizza.
They see
the effort from the Scots. Why can't they stay out on the floor? That's what I'm wondering.
Well, we see Highland's coach calm down.
Well, her team's up by 10.
She was down by 13. She was just yelling.
Well, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
So good. Well, not all coaches are streamers, though.
Yeah.
There are some very calm ones.
I wouldn't be a student coach. I would be like a more laid-back coach.
Have you seen Richfield's coach, Leanne Wise? Doesn't scream at her team. Very calm, very focused, just guides her team.
Yeah, Phil Jackson doesn't yell either.
And he has 10 titles?
Yeah. Every finger.
He's run out of fingers.
He ran out of fingers?
Well, I was going to say, well, he used to have that afro of his.
I mean, if you want to count the New York Knicks when he played, because he actually has two from them.
So 12.
Yeah.
Humboldt on the ropes. Holt.
Whoa, she traveled.
Yes.
Would you say it won the first matchup?
Highland.
Oh, so this might be a sweep here.
It looks that way. Hicks versus Knicks.
Try to make it look fancy. Try to go for the foul. Just draw the foul.
I don't know if it was a measure of fanciness as it was respecting Knicks' blocking abilities.
Up. And she's probably done.
I believe it's her fourth.
Oh, fourth, okay.
But with 2:17 left, I'd say Humboldt's just about done.
Okay, so it is fourth person, my mistake. We got a Humboldt alum over here.
Curtis clutch in this half.
Our cameraman, Mike York, is not happy about this.
I went to Harding, so this is a neutral.
I went to school in Florida, so all this is new to me.
Yeah, until we find a pitcher with a 97-mile-an-hour fastball. LaRock over the back.
Nice one.
Got it. Humboldt's not going to give up. Knicks kicks out. Highland will kill some clock now.
Nice give and go. Whoa.
No foul. Hernandez with the steal, and she didn't realize it. She was expecting a foul. And Clark has no choice but to foul Crenshaw.
So we got a sweep here for Highland Park. And what's the series with Highland Park and Central?
Central swept Highland Park in their series, so Highland Park will have to hope that Humboldt can upset Central one more time in order to force a tie and an appearance in the Twin Cities game. That's what would have to happen. The game's going to be at South, and
so Humboldt would have to upset Central.
Humboldt would have to upset Central, and Highland Park would have to win the remainder of their conference games.
Okay. Not falling.
Gets her own rebound though, but Highland Park.
Tries again, not falling.
Highland Park not going to be as aggressive now.
They hit the wheelchair lady.
They've got this game clinched. And that will move them to 13-8 in the season. And again, if Highland Park could get a win against a team, a ranked team, a quality team, I think they would get some respect. But in their section, they've got a tough assignment with Hill Murray.
Wow.
And seeing Hill Murray twice this season, beating an Eden Prairie team, even though they weren't at full strength, they were still a top 10 team, beating Richfield. Just manhandling a lot of opponents this year. They've had a couple close ones. So I'd be hard-pressed to believe Highland Park could take on Hill Murray in the section.
No, nice pass. Oh, so you got this.
Holt with another rebound.
Has Hill Murray played Richfield twice already?
No, they have one more game at Hill Murray. But that's more for conference implications. They're in different sections. We didn't see a foul from here.
Me neither.
One wasn't called.
I mean, she did step out when she fell.
Wonder why it took them so long to signal that. Moran Stewart, icing on the cake.
That's it right there.
And for the first time in 9 games, this series will not be decided by 10 points or less, but this game certainly played like it.
Whoa.
Highland Park will move to 13-8 on the season. Humboldt will fall to 11-10. But the score was not indicative of how this game played out, but we have a 27-point swing from the start of this game to the finish.
Whoa, off the foot.
Players of the game, Angelina Hicks for Humboldt, 22 points. Kianda Nix for Highland Park. I lost count as to how many blocks she picked up.
The Nix and Hicks show, as you were saying earlier.
Just like last year. So we'll do our best to get an award with both Hicks and Nix following the conclusion of this game. And a game that lived up to its billing. But you have to give credit for the adjustments Highland Park made in the second half, especially with rebounds.
Rebounds, their post players, production. And most of it is just Humboldt was too many errors. Not handling the ball, jumpers not shooting, not making free throws.
And one thing you may not notice was LaRock that was scoreless. And she's going to finish the game with 8 points. Unfortunately, they're all for naught. That did not count. That would have been a field goal for Rachel Womack. Highland Park wins 76-64 and gets the conference sweep and stays one game behind Central in the St. Paul City Conference standings. So that does it from up here. We're going to go down to the court and get interviews with Hicks and Nix in a moment. Mike Peden here with Keonda Nix, and every time we come to a Highland Park game, you seem to step up big, and you came up big again. 23 points, 14 in the second half, and a number of blocks. You came through in the clutch.
We were down, so I thought I had to step it up, help my team out.
Rebounding was key in the second half. What adjustments did you make to shut Humboldt's rebounding, especially on the offensive side of the glass?
Just get in front of people and move them back.
Now, this is the first time in 9 games this series was not decided by 10 points or less. And while you won by 14 or so, the game did not indicate that. Describe what this series means to you, because the last few games it's been very tough, intense, and competitive.
Yeah, with Humboldt it's always a good game, tough game. We love their crowd. We go back and forth, so it's a good competition.
This means you stay one game behind Central. You're going to need some help, though, in order to tie Central and get a Twin Cities appearance. And so what does Highland Park look to do as your head coach is celebrating the victory? What does Highland Park need to do in its final few conference games to stay in the race?
Pick it up, work hard in practice, and bring it in the game.
And describe, the play of the game was a three-pointer that gave Highland Park the lead, and then you came through, just found your shot. You struggled a bit in the first half. How did you find that stroke in the second?
Just putting it off the backboard. That's what my coach told me.
And is there anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching on TV or online?
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Hi, sister, everybody. Thanks for coming out, seeing me.
Well, big performance tonight. I'm sure your family loved it. The Highland Park fans loved it. This is a great game. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Keonda Nix, Highland Park's player of the game. Mike Peden with Angelina Hicks, Humboldt's player of the game, 23 points. A 27-point swing tonight altogether from this game. Strong first half, and what did Highland do in the second half to disrupt you?
They just basically wanted it more than our team, and they was trying harder, getting more boards and making their shots.
Describe the intensity of this series, because until tonight, the last 8 games have been decided by 10 points or less, and every time Highland and Humboldt play each other, it's almost like a Super Bowl.
I don't know really what to say to that, but.
It's okay, we're not quizzing you. You won't be graded on this.
They came out first half not doing as good as they usually do. And then they came out second half just wanting to beat us, and they wanted to go for conference, win conference.
St. Paul City Conference has a lot of quality teams, though. Your team upset Central once. You'll be looking to do that again next week. How do these last few games help you prepare for section play as you try to get into the Class A state tournament?
They make us work harder, want us to win. Since we lost this one, can't get conference, so we're going to try to go for state.
And your thoughts, perhaps, on what you learned from this game, from this series, that will help you in the final week of conference play?
It would do us good, knowing what we did wrong, the turnovers and missed layups. Make us better. Our mistakes now will make us better.
Well, there was some positives tonight. Lachey Holt, again, had another big performance on the boards, and Laroque came through late. A lot of younger players stepped up, and Humboldt has a lot of depth that, if you just looked at the paper, you may not notice.
Yeah, as long as we all work together, we'll be a good team.
And is there anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching on TV or online, maybe your older sisters, your younger sisters, anyone else?
Yeah, my family and my dad. Yeah.
Well, no matter the outcome, the Hicks family has helped revitalize a Humboldt program and turn them into a very competitive squad. This was a great game, even though the outcome didn't go your way. Highland and Humboldt, always fun to watch.
Yeah.
Thanks for taking time to speak with us, and good luck in the last week.
Thank you.
Angelina Hicks, Humboldt's player of the game. That does it from here. Highland Park wins 76-64. For everyone here at TSB Television, I'm Mike Peden. Thank you for watching.